a little boy, 10 years old, here in town in Las Cruces, was out playing in the desert, and he tripped on a piece of this tusk, which is found in three different sections, and brought the piece home and talked to his dad about it, and they knew it was on privately owned land. It didn't belong to them. So they asked, decided what to do, and they contacted the university about it. And we determined whose land it belonged to, and looked into it, and got permission to go out there and look, and found that there was, in fact, a whole skull of this fossil gomphotheres, what most people would call a mastodon. A stegomastodon would look to any of us like an elephant. I mean, it would look just like an elephant. The technicalities are based on the teeth. The fossil is probably about 1.2 million years old, and that's based on other fossils that have been found nearby. Nothing near this complete, mind you. For the several types of elephants that we have in the area, this is probably one of the more common of them, but they're still very rare. This may be the only the second that was found in New Mexico. And it took us some months to get everything in line, to get the permissions and the money to do it and make arrangements, but we went out there and recovered it. It's not a small project. I mean, it might seem like you could just go out there and dig something up, but it takes a lot of planning. We needed to buy materials from specialty places that deal with preservatives, for example. All these things took time to get in line. And we also needed to get a hold of some student volunteers to get involved. So all these things took a few months. When people find out about these things, they might be tempted to go out there and see what they might find themselves and tear up the land on the one hand, or they might actually hurt themselves. And we also had a right to be concerned about the safety of the fossil themselves. It might seem as though these are very robust and you could just go out there and dig it up, but in fact, once the sediments are removed from the sides of them, they start to fall apart immediately and literally fall into tiny, tiny little bits. So it has to be done very carefully by somebody who knows how to go about doing it.
So the larger brush was to remove the sediment. It didn't have anything on it, and it was just to brush away the dirt from the bone itself. And then we used the screwdriver to break up large pieces of sediment, like not exactly on the bone, like away from it, so we could break off like a large, so if this much was off the side of the fossil, we would knock about this much off of the with the screwdriver just to like get it out of the way. And then we start brushing till we get close enough. I was kind of in charge of like the chemicals. So we have butvar and we have perloid and like acetone, stuff like that. So as we were brushing away the fossil, as soon as we move it from the sediment, we need to put a type of hardener on there. So the structural integrity, otherwise it would just crumble after a few days being left in the sun. So I'll just slowly brush away and then paint, brush a little bit, paint, brush a little bit, paint.
It took us about a week of actual excavation to get the skull, and the upper part of the skull is deceiving. It's actually mostly hollow, and the surface of the bone is eggshell thin. Careful to put plaster and wood braces around it, because even with the hardener, the fossil won't support its own weight. Little by little, we can remove the plaster and apply more preservative as we go. Under the best of circumstances, these things take years. And I have every hope and expectation that this specimen will ultimately end up on exhibit, and this little boy will be able to show off to his friends or even his own children when he's older and say, look what I found here right in Las Cruces.